short. 6 runs. A low flat 6. The square leg. Not a good ball, pulled down by Sandhu.
Dreadful delivery this. Real long hop.
So still around about 2 or 3 and over. Much the same all the way through. Some cheeky singles being taken, and at times when I do risky ones. Dujon on 25 to face. And he's called it on. And he's worked the miracle for India. That's the wicket they desperately needed. Dujon somewhat unlucky there. Tried to pull the bat out the way, I fancy. Just caught the inside edge and pulled it on. So he goes. 119 now for 7 in the 42nd over.
Well, funny things happen at this game. Starts the play, decides it's too wide, tries to get his bat out of the way, hits the bottom edge and into his stumps. Great blow for the West Indies. Dujon played very, very well indeed. Looks as though he will be a very good player in the making. But this game thrown wide open again.
The trick nearly worked. Moved it down the hill, caught the outside edge. Roberts gets a single.
And the edge just thick enough for it not quite to carry. A tremendously tight contest.
He's edged it this time and he's gone beautifully caught by Gavaskar's slip. And that might well be the final nail in the coffin here for West Indies. Malcolm Rice, who's defended stoutly for a long, long time, falls another victim to Amanah for 18, leaving West Indies 1-24 for 8.
Well, and I think if we have another look at that, we'll see that was pretty wide as well. They've chased these wide ones, the West Indian batsmen. And Sunil Gavaskar making his name as a catcher.
Thinking, trying to work out what's in the batsman's mind, changing his feel. It's clipped away quite nicely by Roberts. Plenty of time to push it through mid-wicket for 2 runs. And defenders should pull this off. They're going to be over the top at close of play. That's out. Yes. Kapildeo finally gets his just desserts. Andy Roberts falls LBW. No doubt at all in Barry Mayer's mind. He went for 4, 1, 26 for 9. And India almost there. Again, that little bit of movement, Chaminath has conjured up the whole of his spell, struck the outside edge. And again, some slight changes on the offside there this time. Gavaskar gone out of slip into gully. Both these batsmen looking quite comfortable at the moment. And particularly getting on the front foot to everything. And that's out. Yes, it's all over this time. Lost his nerve in the end, did Michael Holin. Tried to swing that straight ball to leg. It's another wicket for Alvin Adler. Delighted he looks. 140 all out, West Indies. And the margin of their victory, 43 runs, as India race into the pavilion with the Prudential Cup players. Tremendous victory. Rank outsiders at 33-1 when this competition got underway. And they've beaten West Indies twice, they've beaten Australia, they've beaten England. And they've round off a fantastic fortnight by taking £20,000 in the Prudential Cup. And an observation here for a couple there to receive the trophy from Lord Carr, chairman of the Prudential Assurance Company. Tremendous performance by this Indian side. And here's a man who's been largely responsible for it over the last 2 weeks. Skipper the side quite beautifully, made his own contributions with bat and ball. And this Prudential Trophy, thoroughly deserved. There's something of a suspicion here that it'll go to Amarnath. Indeed it has. Man of the Match award to Mahinder Amarnath. The second time running, collected it in the semi-final. £600 goes to Mahinder Amarnath, his runs at number three and his three late wickets.
Capel, it has been a quite tremendous day, an historic day for Indian cricket. It must be the proudest day in your cricketing life.
That's right, I'm very happy. I'm happy what my team done here today.
Now, they're looking at you back home from Bombay to Calcutta. What do you want to say to all your countrymen beyond being happy?
Come here. We want to come here again next time with the same spirit, and we should do it next time as well.
Clive, as losing captain, what is your reaction to what has been an unexpected and absorbing contest?
Yeah, a lot of people might think so, but I thought that they played very well. We didn't bat as well. We bowled pretty well. I mean, if you restrict the side to 184, you expect to be there or thereabouts. But, we didn't bat well at all.
The innings, were so many ups and downs, weren't there? It looked as if Viv Richards was going to take it away from you, about 50 for one, and he was going like a tank, wasn't he, Captain?
Yeah, I think he went too fast, and we were happy when he was playing too fast, and we were thinking he can give us a wicket any time if he keep on playing like that. Because he wasn't playing for 60 overs, he was playing for 30 overs game.
Right.
So, a target wasn't good enough to fight. But we were just looking for a couple of wickets to come back to the game.
Capel, what is going to happen in the Indian party tonight? Big celebrations for you both?
Well, this occasion will never come like so easy. Yes, we are going to celebrate. Drinks on the house, you can join us. We have, and we played like winners throughout the game, throughout the series. Everybody fight for their life, and they said, we will do it.
And you must both be in agreement that the man of the match should be none other than Mahinder Amarnath. Well played.
Thanks, Peter.
Everybody was so impressed with the way you played the fast bowling when you were batting, and then, of course, these two crucial wickets. What do you want to say about today?
That was the time actually we wanted a breakthrough. And when I got the first one, I think it was very good for the team. Because like Andy and Michael to follow, and the wicket was swimming about. So then Marshall got out, so we were very much in the game at that time.
Is your father over here, or will he be looking at you?
No, I think he's very much at home, so he must have been watching on the TV over there.
Another great